Oh, Distance to the human body, we must also attribute already enough to demonstrate the room of sensors and seasons belongs to the side of inner world. With my bodily senses, I can perceive the same red people that someone else perceives, but I cannot perceive that person's perception of red. Therefore, the essential nature of the human being 29. We must describe this perception as belonging to the soul. Once we are quite clear about this, we will stop looking at inner experiences as mere brain processes or something of that sort. Follows closely on sensation, since one sensation arousing pleasure comes from another displeasure. These are the stirrings of our inner soul life. We need to create an inner world of feelings in addition to the world that works in honor from outside. Then there is a third factor, our will, previously works back upon the outside world, giving the imprint of our own inner being on it. In will activity, the soul flows outward in a sense. The fact that our actions bear the stamp of our inner life is due to some from natural events taking place in the outer world. In this way, the soul sets itself up as something personal and private in contrast to the world outside. It receives stimuli from the outer world, which constructs an inner private world in accordance with them. Bodily existence becomes the basis for soul existence. 3. The spirit nature of a human being. The soul element in a human being is not determined exclusively by the body. We do not wander aimlessly and without direction from one sense impression to another, nor do we respond to every random stimulus that acts on us from outside or through our bodily processes. Instead, we think about our sensations and our actions. By thinking about our sensations, we come to an understanding of 14. Learning geography. Think, by thinking about our actions, we create rational coherence in our lives. And we know that we are only as human beings when we let ourselves be guided by the right thoughts, moving, knowing, and enacting. Therefore, the human soul faces into the necessity. Out of natural necessity, it is governed by the laws of the body, but because it freely recognizes their necessity, it also allows itself to be governed by the laws that lead to correct thinking. Nature subjects us to the laws of metabolism, but as human beings, we subject ourselves to the laws of thought. Through this process, we make ourselves members of a higher order than the one we belong to through the body. This is the spirit in the order, which is different from spirit, as different as it is from the body. As long as we treat these pieces of particles of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, and nitrogen moving around in our body, we do not have a full review. The life of the soul begins only at the point where sensation arises within such movement, where we taste something sweet or taste pleasure.
Thank you.